again. And this is your Sentinel Tile Services Game of the Week.
Spencer Nolan finds Luke Zolman. Gives it back to Samuel. Takes the shot. Misses. On the fast break, easy layup up ahead to Alex Mokas. Ties the game at 4-4 with under a minute and a half to play in the first quarter. Parker Strong with the ball now. Kendall Brandt gives it back to Strong. Strong with the shot. Gives Oyster River the 6-4 lead. Strong drives, and he loses the dribble. Gets it back. Finds Mr. Harling under the basket, and Harling gets the layup. Puts Oyster River ahead 8-4. Darnell with the open look. Can't knock it down. And Lupinacci takes it coast to coast. Puts it off the glass for the layup. Again, hits both, puts Oyster River back ahead 19-17 with a minute and a half to play in the first half. Langdon with the ball, gives it up to Lupicini, ahead to Spinard under the basket. He knocks down the layup, ties things back up. Zolman with the ball, gives it up to Adamino, passes it down to Struthers puts it off the glass.
Brown has hit a bunny because they miss about 10 of them. They should be up by about 10 points right now.
Says a true Co Brown alum. Eden brings it up, gives it up to Struthers. Struthers finds Langdon down low.
Nice pass.
Co Brown takes the lead 24-23. Kerrigan drives to the basket. Brings it away, puts up ahead to Struthers. Struthers in the paint, off the glass, and that's it. 26-25, Co Brown. Co Brown, drop the cards. Eden inbounds it to Langdon, puts up the three. And 29-25, 5 minutes left in the third quarter.
Reserves gonna have to extend their defense because Co Brown's finally hitting their shots.
That's an Oyster River turnover. That's been killing them all night. Struthers with a good move off the glass. 31-25. Co Brown's keeping the pressure up on defense. Oyster River is able to break it. That's Lucas with the ball. Picked away. Nolan brings it up. Loses the handles. That's going to be Alex Mokas all alone, but he can't convert the layup. Kendall Brandt's there for the rebound and putback.
We are back to the first half back and forth. We're going to trade the ball every 5 seconds. See who scores first.
Langdon brings the ball up. To Eden, Nolan. Across the court to Langdon. Puts up the shot, knocks it down.
Nice shot, especially the hand in his face. That's definitely one of the harder shots in basketball.
That puts Co Brown up by 6. Less than 2 minutes left in the third quarter. Has it now for Oyster River, gives it up to Eden. Big rebound for Zolman. Gives it back to Nolan. Across the court to Eden. Eden puts up the three. Knocks it down. Puts Co Brown up 40-31 with less than a minute left in the third.
I'm going to call that an old man three-pointer just because of how it shoots.
That was a very Kevin McHale-esque shot. It up to Mokas. Back over to Harling. Thought about the three. Puts it up at the foul line and knocks down the shot.
They'll definitely need more of that, that's for sure. Seen from Oyster River, they don't seem to have that one guy you can throw it to when you need to score.
At least not tonight, but that was a pickoff. But they can't convert the layup. It's been missed layups and turnovers all night long. That was a great pass, and Struthers converts. a little spin move down low. Gives it back to Brandt. Brandt takes the two. Has it now for Oyster River. Step back, puts up the three, and knocks it down.
Wow.
Makes it a three-point game with 5.5 to play. Certainly not over yet.
Oh, my bias is coming out, my bad.
Lane with the pass up court to Nolan. Gets the layup to fall. 44-39 now, Cole Brown with the lead with 5 minutes to play in the game. Cole Brown is keeping up the pressure on defense. Led to an open three, but they weren't able to knock it down. Langdon brings the ball up the court. Finds Eden. Eden down low to Nolan. That's worked two plays in a row now. Can't get it to fall. Good offensive board by Struthers. Gets that to go. 46-39 now, Cole Brown. Lucas now. Loses the handle. It's another turnover.
I think it's time when you slow it down now. Only look for good shots, which is
what's
like...
What's this we stuff?
Whoops. Did I say we? Subconsciously, that slipped out. The Cole Brown Bears should slow it down and not do that.
Nolan loses his handle. Up ahead. Kendall Brandt can't get the layup to fall. Nolan has it now. It's a 2-on-1. Gets the pass off. Chance for a three-point play now. Cole Brown ahead 48-39 with 3:40 to play. Could make it double digits.
My math right? It's a nine-point game now, so Worcester is going to have to push the tempo a little bit more here if they want to get back in it. Ten-point game now.
Struthers knocks it down at Keene State Education. I'm right there with you. We're good with our numbers.
Kind of, sort of college.
Lucas with the layup makes it an eight-point game. The shot knocks down the three.
I'm not sure why they're leaving that kid open because he's already hit a few.
He's knocked
tonight.
Down a few.
Yeah.
He's got a chance to put Cole Brown ahead back by double digits. That Kevin McHale shot doesn't fall. But quick off the line and gets the intercepts the pass. Then a nice pass again. And Zolman gets the layup. 45-44, Cole Brown, less than a minute to go. And that's going to about do it here. Cole Brown wins it 59-44 over Oyster River. Remains a perfect 3-0 on the year. So I'm here with Coach Smith after Cole Brown's 59-44 win over Oyster River. Obviously, it was your first time out since the holiday break. What were just some general thoughts in today's game?
Well, I was a little worried in the first quarter. I didn't think the team was going to score, actually. It's a rival game. A lot of emotion, positive emotion, respect for one another. So I think we were trying a little too super pumped early. But defensively kept us in the game.
Sure.
So that was what I was hoping that we could do. For 32 minutes, and then they came through with that. So,
and you touched on it defensively. I mean, your press did give them a hard time, and they had double-digit turnovers in the first half. I mean, was that a focal point for you guys, the press and that defense?
Yeah, defense has to be our hallmark if we're going to be successful this year. And we've been improving. We still have a ways to go. Our rotations are still a little sloppy at times, but for the game tonight, it was pretty solid for most of the game.
And then Jen picked it up right away. You guys came out in the second half, looked like a new team, you know, settled into everything. Your offense was flowing, everything was clicking. What happened during halftime? What was the talk like, and what were the adjustments
made? Just the things that we had to do. We had a lot of opportunities early in the game, and we missed layups, and we got the ball into the rim. We passed the ball out a few times, and I think it was just getting into the things that we do best and running our offense, and they came around pretty well. But defensively, and the bench gave us some big minutes in the first half.
Yeah.
We were in a little bit of foul trouble, and um, you know, I thought the bench really came through for us.
You're a perfect 3-0 now in the year. I know this is a 15-point win on the scoreboard, but
no, I'm sure it was tough. Could have gone either way. Thank you, gentlemen. See you. Have a good night.
Yeah, I'm sure you won't have a hard time getting your team to practice after this.
Yeah, no.
Even with the 15-point win.
No, it was. And we have the Grizzlies of Goffstown on Friday night, and that'll be another tough game for us.
Awesome. Well, congratulations, Coach. Great win. Adam Eden and McCormick Struthers after their win over Oyster River today. Obviously, a great game for you guys today. I'll start with you, Samuel. First game back from winter break, you know, it was a slow start, 4-4 after the first quarter. I mean, it was just a matter of getting the cobwebs out there, or what can you say about that first?
Well, coming out of the locker room, we're just all amped up. It's a rivalry game against Boys from Oyster River. We've been playing against them for a while, and played with a lot of the kids, AAU, on the same AAU team. So we're just excited. Just got to take a step back and regain our focus and then go out and execute.
So is this a friendly rivalry kind of thing where you guys know the players, you played with them, it's not so much a grudge match?
Yeah.
Awesome. And you had a big game on the scoreboard today. I think you had a game-high 21 points. What was clicking?
Just got the ball in the post, and I don't know, teammates just kept finding me. Easy buckets.
And what can you say about your second half? I mean, again, like we just talked about, it was a slow first half. You guys came out, it looked like a new team in the second half. Things were clicking, you were getting the ball down well, you guys were making your layups. What changed there?
I think we settled down. The first half, I think we were a little nervous. Then second half, we just settled down, got back to the basics, played defense.
And Adam, we were impressed with your play defensively. The press was huge. I think you guys forced, double-digit Oyster River turnovers in the first half alone. You were a big part of that. What was the defensive effort like today?
That's just the way Cobran usually plays defense. We're usually not a very high-scoring team. We pride ourselves in getting a lot of pressure on ball. We're a very in-shape team, and we just had to make them make mistakes to make it easier for us on offense.
All right, thanks a lot, guys. Appreciate it. Congratulations.